We are in the middle of transformative era for structure and molecular biology in terms of resolution of data and quantity of data that are available. In order to understand the complexity of this data, we need multi-scale disciplines that can afford to extract molecular principles that are occurring at the different scale. Because in fact, life occurs at the multi-scale. Our research tackles this multi-scale by studying three levels of complexity: the molecular events underlying biological functions, the complex cellular processes, and individual cells, and how these interact and communicate within colonies or tissues. We need to integrate disciplines and to bring together people with different scientific background to work together in this common endeavor. And this is what ISMB is for.
So I study the malaria parasite, which is called Plasmodium falciparum. And what I'm fascinated by is how this very tiny parasite can change its cell morphology as it moves through different stages in its life cycle. So it needs to encounter very different environments in the human host and the mosquito host. And this little cell is able to really adapt to and thrive in these different environments. Malaria is a very large global problem, and it's going to become a bigger problem as climate change continues to become more severe. And in order to come up with innovative ways to combat this disease, we need to study the fundamental biology of the parasite. The beauty of the data that we collect is that it's in 3D. So we can really not only solve structures of proteins, but also look at how they relate to each other and different compartments within the cell.
So my research looks at creating statistical methods to understand a specific mechanism in the immune system. The reason why we do this sorts of research, or why I do it, is if we have a better understanding of normal, let's say, immune function and the variety and breadth of it, then we can also identify when things go wrong. So that is important in terms of disease diagnostics, but also in developing therapeutics. In four biological systems, we have a vast amount of data. The data is collected at multiple scales, and it incorporates, to some extent, temporal dynamics as well. And in order to deal with that data and actually extract signal from it, I use statistical methods as well as computational methods. So the tying together of these two disciplines allows us to extract information from the vast amount of data we actually collect.
The recent Nobel Prizes in physics and chemistry have demonstrated that advances in computer science are breaking into classical scientific disciplines. Artificial intelligence and computational methods, combined with basic disciplines like biochemistry, biophysics, and biology, will help in disentangling the complexity of life. By doing this, we envisage that our contribution will lead to holistic approaches to global health and therefore contribute to future societal challenges.